So this talk is going to be very different, as I said, as the quick one I did in the panel. This is really about networks, so to speak. So it's not about just, you know, two devices talk to each other, but the more complicated network, as we have seen a few talks now in the previous session that also have this paradigm. Why theory and practice? So I'm a guy, computer scientist, who just happens to like both somehow. So these are some of the conferences I published. Now, whether you're a theoretician or a practitioner, you maybe recognize more the left-hand side or more the right-hand side. So it turns out I used to do theory, but then more and more I like to do practical things as well, and now it's all a bit mixed and I cannot help it anymore. But so the reason I present this talk here is that in sensor networks, it's really a very nice area where these two things go together. Okay, so that's something I like about the area. And I'm going to talk about three stories, basically, where theory meets practice in my talk. And I'm going to start out with just wireless communication. Okay, so this is the basis of many things in sensor networks. And I would like to explain a bit what are some really interesting theoretical problems in wireless communication. And in particular, I want to talk about so-called capacity. That's how many bits per bandwidth, per space can you transmit? And when I started out looking at these questions in sensor networks, I was told about the protocol model. So what is the protocol model? So here you have four nodes. Green nodes want to transmit to blue nodes, and the model was explained like this in many textbooks, that you basically transmit a message wirelessly, but of course the transmission cannot be guided towards some direction, so it's kind of goes in all directions, so everybody within the circle can basically receive the green transmissions. But there's more to it. I was also told that there's something called interference range, which is kind of like a larger range. And everybody in this range can maybe not detect the signal anymore, but it still gets interference. It still knows that something's going on, and in particular, it will be disturbed by this interference. So for instance, if the right green node on my picture here is transmitting at the same time as the left green node, then the left blue node cannot get the signal anymore, cannot decode the message anymore from its neighbor, because it's in the interference range of the green node. Okay, so that's the kind of story you get told when you enter this domain.